Hello and good morning. This is Dr. Karthik Gunasekaran from the Metromale Clinic, urologist, andrologist and sexologist. We're based in Chennai. We have branches at T Nagar, Thoraipakkam, and our newest branch is at Porur. At the outset, even before I begin, I would like to wish you all a very, very happy, healthy and prosperous Diwali. Diwali celebrations are in full swing here at the Metromale Clinic. I thought I'd take time out to address a very important topic today, and that is the topic of genital warts. Now, I'm seeing a lot of patients with genital warts present to my clinic. I see both men and women, more so in men. The age group of roughly between about 20 and 40 years. Now, how do these warts present? These warts are also known as like condylomas or venereal warts, and these are caused by a virus known as the human papilloma virus. Now, the human papilloma virus has about 100 strains, and of these 100 strains, about the type 6 and 11 is probably the common strains that cause the genital warts infection in men and in women. Now, how do these actually present? Now, when patients come, they either come with like small swellings, which are either flat, slightly raised above the surface, or they could be presenting as papules, which are like slightly bigger and more elevated from the surface, or they could present as huge cauliflower-like growths, which are really unsightly. Now, where are the common locations these warts present? If you look at that, usually they are presenting in the inner part of the thighs, they could present in the scrotum, they could present in the glands of the penis and inside the foreskin. These are probably the commonest areas. They could also present in the anal region, the anocutaneous region, that is where they commonly present. Now, when they present, I mean, these viruses, how are they transmitted? Now, how does the HPV get transmitted? Transmission usually happens because of sexual intercourse. It could happen because of sexual toys that people share after using from one person to the other. It could also be shared mainly because of just skin to skin contact. Now, this is one of those like infections which you have to be really careful about, because even though if you're protected by a condom, you can still share this virus to a partner. So be very, very careful about the genital warts. And the most important thing is, these things become asymptomatic or remain asymptomatic for a very, very long period of time. Meaning, if you do contract a genital wart infection, it is not necessary immediately it has to show. So it probably takes about like 6 months before the genital wart infection becomes very, very obvious. So I've told you about the warts in general. I've told you like what causes the warts, how it comes, how it spreads, and what are the types of strains of the HPV that can cause. Now, in my next video, I'm going to talk to you about the complications of genital warts and how primarily to treat them. So, have a safe and happy Diwali, and please keep writing to us. And if you do like our videos, like please hit the like button. Till I see you next time, nice talking to you.